Hi there, Taurus, and welcome back to Star Lourdes Tarot. I'm going to be doing your weekly tarot forecast for the week of October 15th through to the 21st. I went ahead and shuffled the cards and laid them out. Let's see what kind of energies are around for Taurus. First of all, we have the Nine of Wands in the upright position, followed then by the Eight of Wands in the upright position. And next we have the Queen of Cups reversed, followed by the Four of Swords reversed. And lastly, we have the Page of Wands in the upright position. Okay, I'm going to go ahead now and interpret this read for you guys. Okay. First of all, for your overall energy, you have that of the Nine of Wands in the upright position. This card generally speaks of standing your ground. You have fought a lot of battles, have come over a made it over a lot of different challenges, and this is the Wounded Warrior card. He's fought all of these battles, but he's standing there and he's ready to fight another day should he have to. I often find this card comes up in situations where people might be feeling a little bit defensive, a little bit battle weary, but, you know, sort of on guard. However, usually it's just more of a feeling, it's more of an energy than an actual something that is, you know, transpiring and happening in your actual reality. It could be that something has happened in the week prior to that sort of put some Tauruses on this sort of path of defensiveness. Now, you come into the week of the 15th with the Eight of Wands in the upright position. The Eight of Wands is basically a card of swift communication. For any of you that, say, are dating online, it could be that you're getting a lot of action, a lot of activities, going back and forth, lots of communication, text messages, things like that. For others of you, it could be if you, say, have applied for a job or an apartment or things like that, you're getting a lot of responses and a lot of things going back and forth. So it's definitely a card of movement, activity, some even travel, perhaps. So there's a lot of action and a lot of activity coming in right off the hop on the week of the 15th. The next card you have here is the Queen of Cups in the reverse position. The Queen of Cups, it's a court card, so it could be representing a person. If it's representing a person, it could be representing someone of the water signs, which is Cancer, Scorpio, Pisces, Sun, Moon, or Rising. It could be male or female. Now, this person, when they're in the upright position, this is someone who is really compassionate, understanding, very caring, and loving. You know, she's very emotionally stable and can sometimes help us if we're having some issues or troubles and so forth. However, the card is in the reverse position, so it could be for some of you, this Queen of Cups could be representing a parent, or it could be representing a boss or someone in authority that you're dealing with, and maybe this person is lacking compassion towards you in a certain situation, or there's been an upset or something like that. And if it's not representing a person, it could just be representing your own energy, Taurus, where you're just feeling emotionally a little bit off, a little bit emotionally unbalanced, feeling like you can't get a handle on your emotions, or you're maybe not feeling so compassionate towards another person or a situation that you normally would. But it could be that you're just not feeling it for some reason this week. It could have something to do with all of this communication and information and so forth. Perhaps it's, you know, this communication is about this person, and you know, you could have heard something about this person. It could be, you know, rumors about a boss or a coworker or something like that, or even a family member. And as we move towards the weekend of the 20th, 21st, we have the energies of the Four of Swords in the reverse position. Four of Swords, when it's upright, this is someone sort of taking a much needed rest. Sometimes it can represent a weekend getaway, things like that, and or even recuperating after illness, injury, things like that. However, it's in the reverse position, good news. It's if any of you have been feeling ill or under the weather or so forth, and have taken your time out to rest and recuperate, you could be now seeing yourself coming out of that phase and getting back into action, which is very good, because look what the next card is the Page of Wands in the upright position. Wonderful energy. This is very youthful energy. This is also a court card, so for some of you could be representing a person of the fire signs, which is Aries, Leo, Sag, Sun, Moon, or Rising, male or female. It could be that this person, it's towards the weekend, right? So it could be coming right into the weekend. It could be that this person is offering you something. He's coming in. If it is representing a person, it could be that this person is coming in to offer you something. For some of you, it could be offering to take you out on a date, or, you know, just ask you to maybe, you know, start something with them, start a romance. If you're already seeing them, maybe they want to, you know, take it to another level, that kind of thing. For others of you, it could just be representing a message coming in that is very passionate and very exciting, because the Page of Wands is full of energy. It's youthful energy, and if it's not representing a person, it could just be representing his qualities, which his qualities basically represent something coming, a message coming in pretty quickly. It's in the beginning stages, in the budding stages, because he's just a page. So it could be something really subtle, but it's something exciting. It could potentially be something very exciting. For some of you, it could be, you know, a project, invitation to, you know, do something active, like go on an adventure or something like that. So either way, it's really exciting, and it looks like the Page of Wands gets you out of stagnation and back in action again. So this is very lovely energy to see. I'm not really sure what's going on here at the beginning of the week with the Queen of Cups and the activity and the Wounded Warrior part, but it looks like all's well that ends well, because come the weekend energy, you've got something exciting coming in, and it looks like it gets you up and going again. Okay, Taurus, I hope you enjoyed this reading. If you did, please feel free to like, share, and subscribe. And I want to thank all of you who have been doing that and leaving me comments. If you'd like to book a personal reading with me, the details are in the About section. And thank you all for your support and your donations. It's very much appreciated. Take care. Until next time. Bye for now, Taurus.